Don't we paint the town and all that jazz? I'm gonna boosh my knees and draw my stars and all that jazz. Start the car right over Whoopee spot where the gin is cold and the piano's hot. It's just a noisy hall where there's a nightly brawl and all that jazz.
There's a crowd of 50,000 to see the Grand Prix at East London. An ace British speedster, Stirling Moss, is among the crack overseas drivers competing. There are 24 starters and they're away, with 146 miles to cover over a circuit of almost 2.5 miles. Stirling Moss is out in front almost from the start of the race, and he's fighting a duel for the lead with Chris Bristow, also of Great Britain. The heat and the glare are making conditions unpleasant for the drivers, and the heat in particular is going to take its toll of highly tuned engines. It's Moss from Hanning of Cape Province and Bristow of Great Britain. Accelerators on the floorboard and driving like the wind, Stirling Moss opens up his lead. They're lapping at an average of almost 85 miles an hour. As each circuit is completed, we can appreciate Moss's magnificent driving, particularly his timing as he slides past Love of Southern Rhodesia on a corner. He's a worthy world champion, all right, and he's up against the cream of South African drivers, as well as having a strong challenge from Belgium in the form of Bianchi and Frere. In spite of that, it looked as if nothing could stop Moss except engine failure, and his engine suffered partial failure with 35 miles to go. This brought Frere of Belgium into the picture, moving from number two position into the lead. Stirling Moss limped on to come second ahead of Sid van der Faver of South Africa and Bianchi of Belgium. But it was Paul Frere of Belgium who arrived home first to take the top prize. He had driven a magnificent race and had always been well up with the leaders. So the sixth South African Grand Prix goes to Paul Frere of Belgium, and the first driver to congratulate him was Stirling Moss, who had set the pace while his luck held. But it's all part of the motor racing game.
Flags of many nations fly at the South African Grand Prix in East London. 90,000 people see 275,000 rand worth of cars compete for the world championship. Jack Brabham, former world champion, chats to Sid van der Faver. Guest of honour Stirling Moss casts a critical eye at some of the drivers. Jim Clark seems cool and collected. Graham Hill dons his crash helmet in preparation. Ernie Peterser gets ready too, as does Doug Serrurier. Neville Ledala is driving car number 20, and Tony Maggs is in number 9. One or two words before the race, and as the flag comes down, a deafening roar of exhausts and tyres sends the drivers on their way. From the start, Jim Clark surges ahead. On his tail is Graham Hill. It's round the S's now as a bunch of the drivers negotiate these tricky turns. Down the straight, and it's interesting to note that after 35 laps, Clark lapped all but four drivers. Although there's quite a distance between Hill and Clark, many miles have still to be covered. Bruce McLaren, driving a Cooper, has his stablemate Tony Maggs on his tail, and these two give the crowd some exciting moments. And then it happened. In the 63rd lap, smoke started to belch from Jim Clark's engine. He was called into the pits. Graham Hill took over the lead. Examination of Clark's engine proved that he could not continue. Well up with the leaders is Neville Ledler, driving one of the finest races he's ever driven. But it's Graham Hill who keeps his lead right until the end and comes tearing down the straight past the checkered flag. Second home is Bruce McLaren. So the World Championship for 1962 goes to Graham Hill. And if anybody deserved a bowl of champagne, it's him. Thousand spectators line the Grand Prix racetrack in East London for the last big international race of 1963. From Potter's Pass leading down to Rifle Bend, the leaders begin to string out, and in front in a green and gold Lotus is world champion Jim Clark. Cocobana Corner is a sharp elbow bend leading up to Beach Straight, and so to Butts Bend and the S's. Jim Clark is firmly in front at this point, and not far behind are a bunch of fancied drivers: Jack Brabham, John Surtees in a Ferrari, Dan Gurney in a Brabham, and Graham Hill in a BRM. Thank you.